Well, she doesn't use any flux, it's fire welding. Oh no, have to be British.
No, I try and avoid flux if I possibly can.
One disadvantage is it always bleeds forever. It always bleeds forever.
I think if you finish something and you've got flux on it, it always comes out whether you put, when you put the paint on. Of course, it always goes into the bits where you can't get.
A little bit of salt in a Canadian winter.
It starts to spark. It's getting me to a point where it's starting to spark up.
Yeah, that's right. Well, in here.
It's hard to tell with the daylight.
It's a critical thing.
And it'll be a good solid weld.
We're going to have to do some other welds on this later on. I'm just shaping this around at the outside. I'm going to close it up. Just shape it. Okay, right, we're going to make the center piece. And basically this again is split down and turned up. Outside and then eventually take an overall welding heat and fuse them all in. When you're fire welding, you know, very often the first weld is simply just a tack, just to get it stuck, and before you lose the heat you put it back into the fire to take the next one. If your fire's clean,
Yeah.
to the point, yes.
Did you buy that tongue especially for that?
Yeah. You don't do that by hand?
No, I'm doing it.